Your eyes are hers, like hers and mine.
Okay.
My eyes are.
So today is.
Do you have to have a floor like them?
Today is Friday.
I like the way it is.
And we are going to practice our solar salutation sequence. Yeah.
And, is this what we usually have?
Yeah. Now, the funny thing about yoga is it's about flexibility. and so often, you know, here we are, and we're about to do practices which are to increase our flexibility. And we end up like, you know, things have to be a certain way. And that's all about attachment and aversion, those two sides of the coin, the black and the white. And so it's, if we can get a little, remember, you know, to have a sense of humor. Sometimes that's really difficult. But my teachers would always say to me, okay, now get over it.
And
it used to bug me because I would be like, but, and they say, okay, so now get over it.
That is true.
Yeah, and you know, it takes a little bit to get to that point.
Yes.
And depending on the level of, you know,
patience,
and also the level of discomfort. I mean,
you're right.
You know, it's not to belittle real issues, but I think, you know, if we can learn to have a consensus, you know, we'll be okay. And a lot of our practices we do with the eyes closed. So let's start, in fact, with the eyes closed, as we usually do. Today's class is the Solar Vitalization Technique, Surya Namaskāra. And we'll be practicing this with the Bījākṣara Mantras, the 5, 6 seed mantras, Prāṇa, Hrīṁ, Hrūṁ, Rāṁ, Rāṁ, Rā, that we do with each of the positions in the Solar Salutation series. So before we do that though, let's just take a moment to ground and settle down. Notice how our breathing is moving in our body today. We may have just experienced feeling a little upset and noticing that our breathing was shallow and quick. So let's just let it smooth down like the calm waves of beauty and bliss that Mother gives us, that sweet lullaby of the breath. To the body. breath traveling into the center of the skull. Practice of the solar vitalization with the first position, pranamasana, palms together at the heart, and the mantra, Om Ram, exhale, inhale. Is Om Ram. Exhale, inhale. Ashtangasana, we widen the knees a little, lower our heart between the knees just a little, extend our chin towards the floor out in front of us, about 2 feet in front of us. This creates a little bit more of an extension in the upper back. Draw the shoulders onto the back, and the mantra is Om Hra. Exhale, inhale. Om Hra. And now peel up your head and your shoulders, coming up into what we call Cobra pose or Bahujangasana. Good. Keep sending your tail back behind you. The mantra is also Om Hra. Exhale, inhale. Om Hra. And then exhale, just lower your head back into the plank position, the flat back, tucking the chin for position 8, also Parvatasana or Adho Mukha Svanasana, Parvati's pose, or some call it downward dog. The mantra is Om Hraum. Exhale, inhale. Om Hraum. And now pressing with your hands and lengthening your spine with your inhalation, come back up to your upright position slowly, just to keep that nice sense of equilibrium. Good. And bring the palms together at the heart for position 9. Extend the left leg this time. Flex the toes. Draw the right leg back, the heel in. Draw up on the pelvic floor. Lightly touch the tip of the tongue to the roof of the mouth. We've got 2 mudras going, Ashwini Mudra, the horse mudra on the pelvic floor, and Jiva Mudra, the tip of the tongue in the mouth. This mantra is Om Hraim. Exhale, inhale. Om Hraim. Exhale, release the hands, draw back on the left foot. The right foot comes forward, and again, place the hands on the knees for a moment, and prepare to exhale and fold forward from the hips. Come all the way down, laying your belly down on your thighs. Let your arms drape over beside your knees. Let your head hang, your face soften for Padahastasana, position number 10. Pada means foot, and hasta means hand. So we have foot-hand pose. Padahastasana. And here the mantra is Om Hrum. Exhale, inhale. Om Hrum. And then place your hands on your knees. And with full awareness of your breath, wait for your inhalation and come up with your inhalation to your sitting position. And then extend your arms and your hands to shoulder height. I can see you. And they can either stay there or go up. And you can look up, extend your heart, soften your face. This is Hasta Uttanasana, or extended hand pose. This is position 11. The mantra is Om Hrim. Om Hrim. And then exhale, bringing the palms together at the heart for position 12. And in this position.
Excuse me.
That's okay.
It's ring, so I didn't. I'm gonna bother you.
That's quite all right. The mantra is Om Hraum. So exhale, inhale, and the mantra, Om Hraum. And then just release your palms. Very good. So sit tall for a moment and just let the effects of those 12 positions settle with your breath, we're going to practice the series again. This is the solar vitalization technique to stimulate our digestion, our assimilation, and most importantly, our elimination. So we take in foodstuffs, we take in visions through our eyes, we take in sounds through our ears, we take in smells through our nose, and we take in sensations through our skin. And the sixth sense is the mind. So after the five gross sensory organs, our mind continues to mentate, and so we can dream, and sometimes in our dreams we smell things, or we see things, or we eat things. So it all goes on again, but on a much more subtle level. So at some point we assimilate these inputs, and we learn to eliminate that which no longer serves us. So this practice of the solar vitalization technique is to help us have easefulness in our digestion, assimilation, and elimination. A corollary practice is the simha kriya. So let's open our mouths as wide as we can, stick out the tongue, open the eyes wide, draw the skin of the body back towards your tailbone, continue to breathe, draw the shoulder blades back, and relax. Place the palms down, spread the fingers, spread the toes. This time we'll go through that same sequence of opening the face, dilating the eyes, but when we exhale, we'll pitch forward from the hips. So let us all do that. Let's exhale deeply, take a nice big inhalation, and then go into the pose. And relax the body as you come back up. And just for a brief interlude, let's let the arms dangle. Make some circles with the shoulders. Nice big circles, go both ways. Very good. Make some circles with the hands and the wrists.
Feel good.
We want to move all the joints and the glands. Just a little bit of sideways movement with the head. Move your jaw and your lips. Squinch the face. Good, release that. Make some big circles with your spine. Bring your heart towards me and over each of your thighs, and roll your spine back towards your chair. Good, so you're bringing your heart forward and then back. Kind of like, here it is, and then you take it back inside the cabinet. So you open the cabinet, and then you close the cabinet. Okay, good. So here we go with our second solar vitalization sequence. Prāṇa-māsana. Prāṇa is the energy and asana is the pose. So Prāṇa-māsana is this pose that we begin with, where we just draw in the energy, our eyes closed, our spine, head and neck and trunk as straight as possible. Feel the awareness of your heart cave, and in that heart cave, the mantra Om Ram arises. You can join us if you wish. Exhale, inhale. Om Ram. And then inhale the arms out in front or overhead. Straight arms, extend, feel like you're reaching up through your spine. Second position, Hasta Uttanasana. The mantra is Om Hrim. Om Hrim. Exhale, like a big swan dive. Fold forward from your hips, laying your belly down on your thighs. As you exhale, let your arms wrap around the outside of your legs. Let your head nod in. Your face is soft. Your eyes are soft. Your jaw and tongue are soft. Feel how the breath is expanding into your low belly and your low back. Your hands are near your feet. This is the Padahastasana, or feet and hand pose. The mantra is Om. Prune. Om prune. Place your palms on your knees, and on an inhalation, lengthen your spine and come up, pressing down with your feet, and your hands come up slowly so there's no sense of discomfort. Catch your breath. Bring your awareness to your palms and bring them to your heart cave. Again, extend the right foot, spread the toes if possible, energetically draw the left heel in. Scissor your legs together so your buttocks and your Ashwini Mudra, the pelvic floor, rise upwards. Tip of the tongue lightly against the roof of the mouth. Those two mudras, Ashwini Mudra and Jiva Mudra. This is the pose called the kneeling horse pose, Ashwa Sanchalanasana. This is the kneeling horse turning pose. Here the mantra is Om Hrai. Exhale, inhale, Om Prime. And then exhale, lower the hands, draw back on the right foot, left foot comes forward, and place the hands on the knees, keep a flat back like a plank, and exhale, fold forward from the hips, laying your belly down on your thighs, keep your chin tucked a little, your head is not nodding here. You're visualizing a line through your entire spine. And this is the Parvatasana pose, Parvati's pose, also known as Adho Mukha Svanasana, or downward dog pose. The breath is flowing into your lower abdomen and your back of your ribs, your kidney region. And this is pose number 5 in the series. The mantra is Om Hraum. Om Hraum. Now, pose number 6, Ashtangasana, or 8-point pose. You widen your knees slightly and lower your heart between your knees and your hands. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points right there. And then your spine is long. You're sticking your chin towards the floor in front of you about 2 feet. And the mantra here is Om Ra. Exhale, inhale. Om Ra. And now peel up your head and your shoulders for Bahujangasana, Cobra pose. Keep extending your tail back there. The The mantra is also Om Ra. Om Ra. And exhale, lower your head back to the plank position. Downward dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana, also known as Parvati's pose, Parvatasana. The mantra here is Om Raum. Exhale, inhale. Om Raum. And press down with the feet, press down with the hands, and come up slowly. Just keeping that easefulness, what we call Sukha, Shtira Sukha Asana. Steadiness and sweetness. Sometimes these poses bring up the coughing, so it's good. You know, just kind of clearing out the bronchial tubes and the esophagus and your mucus there. Palms together at the heart, extend the right leg, spread the toes, draw back the right foot, left leg's extended. So whichever way you did it the last time. Good. And exhale, inhale. The mantra is Om Hraim. Om Hraim. And then release the palms, draw back on that left foot, right foot front comes forward. And now you will sit tall for a moment, just to lengthen with your inhalation. Then exhale, fold forward one more time. From the hips, laying your belly down. Let your arms drape alongside the legs and let the head hang. Let the forehead and the eyes soften. Watch how the breath is expanding into the abdomen, into the low back and the low ribs. This is Pada Hastasana, or hand to foot pose, position number 10. And here the mantra is Om Hrum. Om Hrum. Place the palms on the knees. With your inhalation, come up slowly, pressing down with your hands, pressing down with your feet, just coming easefully with effortless effort back to your vertical position. Let the eyes close for a moment. Settle into your breath. And when you're ready, on your inhalation, sweep your arms forward, up through the shoulder position. And if you're taking them overhead, take them all the way up, extend the arms. Look up with your face, lift your heart, within your capacity. Position 11, Hasta Uttanasana, extended hand pose. The mantra is Om Hrim. Om Hrim. And then exhale. Lower the palms and the arms in a nice big sweep. Bring them into your heart chakra. Palms together for the final position 12. Prāṇa Masana. So you're gathering together the feeling sense of the life force, the elan vital, the chi, the prana, gathering it together at the fourth chakra region in the center of the chest, in the heart cave. And the Bij mantra here is Om Ram. Exhale, inhale. exercises. So that's very good. It's a lot. I know that I'm feeling warmth from that practice. And it's designed, that's why it's called the solar vitalization practice. It's going to bring heat. When you want to digest something, you need heat, either in the form of good enzymes in the stomach. We have acid in the stomach. You know, to dissolve the food, too much is too much, but we do need it there. It's quite amazing that the stomach has really such caustic material there, and it can handle it there, right? But you don't want it anywhere else in the body because it really is hydrochloric acid. It's like the real stuff, amazing stuff. So we're keeping that in vital form by these practices, by these movements, lowering the body, bringing it back up like this, you know, so good. It's a subtle force, okay? And that takes us to the end of the class, and it's Friday's class. So let us all just return to our starting position with our head, neck, and trunk as straight as possible without exceeding your capacity. Your head, neck, and trunk as straight as possible. Enjoy the feeling sense of the breath in the nostrils, the nasal areas, the two gates to the body, the lunar on the left and the solar on the right. The gate of the moon, the gate of the sun. The ha and the ta, ha ta. That become fused and unified with through this yoga, ha ta yoga. And the flow of that prana through sushumna, the central channel, to the space behind the eyes. Sahana. Gesture of humility. surrender. Thank you so much for practicing again.
We did it again.
We did it again.
Marvelous, yes. Marvelous.